Ijeoma Grace Agu. I'm an actor and a producer. Keep watching Broadway TV. Keep supporting us. Don't touch that bell. I'm a mother. I'm an actor. I'm a Christian. I'm a producer. It's based on a web series that I had the privilege of following 3-4 years ago, written by Toyo Fab. So I got the rights to it 3-4 years ago, and over time I had been looking for money to, you know, make it into either a film or a series, and now just happened to be the time to do it. And it tells the story of a couple, the journey to marriage and the journey after, their relationship with their environment, their society, their friends, how they deal with it, how they cope with it, the problems they go through, how they solve it or not. Yeah, that's basically what it's about. It's on a very small budget, so having to shoot on that really small budget, there's so much we could have done. Chief of them planning. There was literally no planning. We just went head first, and I pray we don't sink. Yeah, but aside that, the little budget we had to work with has been the major challenge. But I mean, this Nollywood, we make it happen, so. I'm my worst critic, so I always say I'm proud of where I am now. I want more. I always want more. I want to get better. I want to go further and farther. So, yeah, where I was when I started is not where I am now, but I want to, you know, I want more. So it could be better. But for experience-wise, I love the experience I've garnered over the years. I wouldn't trade them for anything. As an actress, no, but I had been writing before I started acting professionally. As a writer, yes, because I was much younger. I was in my teens, and I used to write for marketers, and it was difficult convincing them that the script they were about to buy was written by this small girl with no makeup, with long skirts, and so they would always insist in very rude and brusque and uncouth manner to prove my mettle, if you know what I mean. But my mama trained me well, and I'm a strong girl. So if not fight, we'll go fight on. As far as the role requires, as far as the role requires, so long as we're not shooting porn. Bless Nebbia's One Room, which shows on her channel, www.bconceptnetwork.tv. Go watch it, guys. Was a bit challenging because I had to play a Yoruba woman and I had to speak the language, and I had to learn that language on set. So if that's what you call challenging, yeah. But no role so far has rattled me, except for the one I'm yet to play next year in Holland. That one is shaking me. Still learning how to balance it. But I'm lucky to have someone who understands what I do and respects it. So when I say, okay, can you pick in the commotion, I'm not at. But I'm an extreme person. I give 100% to whatever I'm focused on at that moment. Everything takes second place. So when I'm at home, I'm a mother, 150%. When I'm acting, I'm an actor, 150%. That's how I've been able to balance it, if that's a balance, yeah. Again, I say I'm lucky because I produce for House 5 Productions, and as a producer, I can say I want my daughter on set with me, you know. I want her to have a room. if I can afford it. So that also affords the family the opportunity to spend more time together. And even when I'm on other sets and I'm allowed, they allow me to come with her, and someone just minds her for me during the course of that production. So, yeah, we trust me, we spend literally every time together. I just want a job. I just want to act. If you call me now, you have a room for me, three scene, four scene, I will grab it with them. I want to act every single day of my life. That's how bad I want it. I'm that dog that pants after a bone. So it's not about, oh, I want that deep character. Trust me, I have played deep characters so much so that people are like, oh, she's always crying. Oh, she's always in a shower. Oh, she's... I've done all that. So I just want to keep acting. I just want to keep being different characters, people that I'm not. I just want to live their lives and see what it is like. You know, and do it believably, you know. It's so easy for your acting to suffer when you're a producer because, you know, everybody is calling on you to make things happen. But what I do is I spend a lot of time doing pre-production. I spend a lot, I will not sleep just to make sure that things are in place. But once I get on set, you dare not disturb me. I've put everything in place. You need this, you know where it is, you know the department head to meet, you know. So it's only when life happens, when situations beyond your control come up, of course you have to assume that role again just because the production must not suffer and the show always goes on. But it's a deliberate effort on my part to make sure it doesn't suffer. So that's why I have every department well covered, well represented by people who have the skills to handle such departments. You gather, because filmmaking is a collaborative effort. It's not one person. It's not just the producer, it's not the director, it's not the actor. We have so many people behind us in the location manager, the location bus driver, as little as that may sound, the welfare, the costume, it's a lot. Props man, if any of these departments suffer, the film suffers. So part of producing is making sure that you get the right people qualified for that job to fit in that space. So that when you have the right people in that space, creating a product, you create a product that is unmatchable, that is beautiful, you know. Ah, plenty. It happens. Sometimes you read the script, it's so unique, so fresh. But then the perspective of maybe the producer, the director is different from yours. And you're like, oh, please don't kill this good material. But I mean, you don't have the final say. So such opportunities do, such instances do happen. But you take it in your stride. It's your work. You're paid to do it. So you bone and do it. Yeah. A lot. Movies down the line, movies that we are producing, series that we are producing, co-producing, I mean, other works that we've been contracted for as House 5 production, and there's a lot. Just keep watching out for what we do, yeah. I love Nollywood. I'm a child of Nollywood. I grew up watching Nollywood. I used to watch a lot of Nollywood films. And now in it, the intricacies of it, and believe me, there are a lot. The hardship, the joy, the pain. Trust me, I don't want any other thing but this. You know, creating what we create with so little. So little help, so little money, so little assistance, and not looking at that. I mean, such a spirit, you can't put it down, and that's why Nollywood is where it is. You don't say, the money is not right. If it's not this amount, I'm not. You can't do that, because it will never be right. Even in Hollywood, the money is never right. I mean, you hear films that have gone above budget, and still, when you talk to these people, they still have complaints. So it's never going to be perfect, but we're not perfect human beings. We're not in a perfect world. So, but you make do regardless. So it's being able to create regardless. That's what makes you proud of yourself at the end of the day, when you remember how you created that with so little. Yeah. Never. I don't even know. I don't know much about money. I don't care for it. I just want it to do what it has to do and keep it moving. I'm never money driven. Never. It's hard, I have to say, because, like I said, I'm an extreme person. I focus, you know, squarely on what's before me. So sometimes I forget he's my husband on set, and if I'm producing, I'm always mean. But I married someone who is very understanding, who is still coming to terms with who I am and willing to come to terms with it. So it's nothing you can trade for anything in the world. So it's hard, but it's rewarding. It's rewarding because you both get to do what you both love to do. It binds you guys together in a very deeper level, on a very deeper level. Not often. Yeah. Well, because if I'm on set, I don't know, cooking. No, but what I do, you have to plan your home. You have to plan your home. Especially if you marry a man that can't cook. I married one. He cannot cook to save his life. But he can clean the house. So we reach a compromise. You clean the house, I cook. You know? And I don't cook every day. When I cook, it's twice a day. And I say I don't cook every day because when I cook in large quantities and I store up. So for the days I'm lazy or the days I don't want to cook, you eat leftover. Oh gosh, that was mean. The world forgets. We live in a fast-paced world that if you do not keep reinventing yourself, if you do not keep, especially for what we do, if you do not keep putting yourself out there, people forget. People's memory, you forget your loved ones that die, I'm aware. People will forget. So if you don't, why should people even remember you? What's there? Remember yourself now and put yourself out there, yeah. They don't owe, nobody owes anybody anything. Yeah, you owe it to yourself to keep being relevant. We still remember Liz Benson. Yes. We still remember Jacques Silva. So what are we talking about? They are still relevant. They are still kicking ass. Sorry. So if you want to be remembered, do what you know you have to be remembered by. And keep doing it. Because we'll forget.